Maria and Reid, have you come here free, and above reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the Lord Christ and His Church? My dear friends, on behalf of Father Inter, I welcome each and every one of you. We gather to honor these two beautiful people before us. Today we come to celebrate and give thanks to God for the love that they have. We honor their parents, their families, the two cultures, the Tongan and the Samoan coming together to unite this man and this woman in the holy bond of marriage before God and before us all. For those of you not of the Catholic faith, I extend a warm welcome to each and every one of you. Talofa and Malolele. And so we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and the peace of God our Father be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate worthily these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind the faults and failings of life, and the many times that we have neglected and taken love for granted. and so officially begins our celebration. Let us now turn and listen to the word of God, and this will be proclaimed first by Siliana and the second, you know, by Anna. Could I invite these two readers to please come forward?
Ko folo fola senesi vai uluaki. Pe folo fola ai otua. Tau ngau hitangata I hotau imisi. O fai fai taki ki hotau wanga. Pe ake nau pule ki heika oi tahi. Moe manu puna oi ata. Moe manu lalata. Io mo uta katoa. Pea moe faahinga totolo, oku totolo I he funga fonua. Pea nae whakatupu e he otua, ae tangata I he imisi o ona. Io I he imisi o e otua, na ane whakatupu ia. Na ane whakatupu a kinaua, koe tangata, moe whewhine. Pea nae tāpua ki I a kinaua, e he otua. Pea nae folofola ki a te kinaua, e he otua, o pehe. Mo whakatupu, mo whakatokolahi, mo whakafonu a mamani. Pea ikuna ia. Pea mo pule, ki heika oi tahi, moe manupuna oi langi. Pea moe mea mo ui kotoa pe, oku totolo I he fonua. Pea nae afio ai otua, ki he mea kotoa pe kone ngāohi, pea tā ko lelei aupito. Pea nae e fiafi, pea nae pongi pongi, koho no aho o no ia. Koe wholawhala tonu ia a e eiki. Thank you.
Falanga, tato te mau mai le tusia Paulo, le e kalesia I Roma, lona matau pue valu, lona fai upue tols fulmatas, se ye oho o le tols fulmal lima, to e si ir fai tau, le fai upue tols fulmal fitu, e whangata mai le fai upue tols fulmal iwa. O le nei, Se asa tato upu I nei mea. A whai ua au mai I a tei tato e lea tua. O ai se whasanga tau mai I a tei tato. O ia lava sa na le whasa oina lo na lava alo. A ua tu ina mai o ia ono I tato ma lava. E le fua I fua mai ea e ia I a tei tato mea uma. Lava whātas mai ia I sea. Wai sena te moa lia le wa filifilia I le atua. O le atua, o le ta uami o te onuina mai, wai sena te whasalaina mai. O ke riso o ia na maliu, a ua toi tū mai lava o ia. O lo e le tūta matau fōi o le atua, o lo o fautua fōi o ia, mō I tātou. Wai se na te whātea e se ina mai tātou I lea lofo ke riso. O le puapua ngā ea, po le atua tawale, po le sāua, po le onge, po le le lavalava, po le pangātia, po le pelu. A ua tātou manu māloa ia I nei mea umalava, o na uia, wa alofa mai a te tātou. A wāwa o mauti noa, e le mawhai e le oti, po le ola, po le angelu, po le ali, po o e malolosi, po o mea I nei o na po, o mea atali, po le mauwarulunga, po le loloto, po se etasi mea na te whaia, e le mawhai e ia mea uma, o na whaatea e se ina mai tātou, I le alofa o le atua. O lo o ia ke riso Jesu, lo tātou o li. O a fionga a le atua. Please rise to welcome the gospel with the Alleluia verse.
Hallelujah. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
And Jesus said to his disciples, "It is not those who say to me, 'Lord, Lord,' who will enter the kingdom of heaven, but the person who does the will of my Father in heaven. When the day comes, many will say to me, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, cast out demons in your name, work miracles in your name?' Then I shall tell them to their faces, 'I have never known you. Away from me, you evil men.' Therefore, everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a sensible man who built his house on rock. Rain came down, floods rose, gales blew, and hurled themselves against the house, and it did not fall. It was founded on rock. But everyone who listens to these words of mine and does not act on them will be like a stupid man who built his house on sand. Rain came down, floods rose, gales blew, and struck their house, and it fell. And what a fall it had." Jesus now finished what he wanted to say, and his teaching made a deep impression on the people because he taught them with authority and not like their own scribes. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Would you please be seated?
Before I offer a few words to reflect on this beautiful day, could I invite Maria's hearers to please come forward? I'd like to share with you a story to help us celebrate this beautiful day. It's a story about a friendship between a man and a woman who were great friends. They weren't lovers, they weren't boyfriend and girlfriend, they weren't even planning to get married like these two. They were just really good friends. Many years ago, there was an airline which is named Polynesian Airline. It took passengers from Sydney, and then to Tonga, and then to Samoa. And they decided to go on a holiday, both to Tonga and to Samoa, but they thought we'll go first to Samoa, and then come back to Tonga, and then back to Sydney. So they booked their flight. But when Polynesian Airline arrived in Tonga, they said there's something wrong with the engine. So they have to spend the night there in Tonga. And of course, all the Palanis were given the Hilton Hotel, and all the Samoan given motels in Tonga. When they got to their place, they said that there is only one room available. They said, "That's all right, we will share the room." But when they got to the room, they looked and they said, "Oh, there's only one bed. What we're gonna do? Let's share the bed as well. We're good friends. You sleep on your side and I'll sleep on my side, and we'll put a pillow in between. We'll be all right. And don't worry, there. This is a good story, okay?" It's always good to tell a story with names, isn't it? So Reid and Maria, I need to borrow the names of my story, please. Later in the night, Maria says to Reid, "Reid, I'm cold." And Reid, as a good friend, said, "I will get up, I'll go down to the reception, and I'll ask them to give us more blankets." But as he was getting out of bed, Maria says, "Wait, wait, wait. Why don't tonight we pretend that we are husband and wife and cuddle up?" And Reid said, what? And Maria said, look, just tonight it's pretend that we're husband and wife. So Reid thinks about it for a little while, and then he lays down on his side of the bed. Maria sees nothing happening, no movement whatsoever, says, oi, what's going on? And Reid said, well, I've been thinking. If we are to pretend tonight that we are husband and wife, you get up and get your own blankets. See, the married people are lucky. It's true. You sure you want to do this? My friends, the fulfillment of our lives as human beings is met by this great desire within all of us to give and to receive love. It is the essence of who we are as human beings, for love presumes a willingness to struggle, to hold hands in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. It is this word love that has brought us here today. But yet we live in a time and an age when they misuse this word love. They throw it from one end to another. They say that music uses the word love or its being in its lyrics. If you look at the newspaper nowadays, there's a whole section devoted to love. If you watch TV late at night, you know, they will even try and convince you that if you want love, just pick up the phone, dial 1-800 number, and you get love. But that's not love. Love is something that is pure and something that is sacred. And we believe that love is God. And so today you are celebrating and mingling the love of God through your sacred vows and the exchange of priests. And it is a day of joy. But before you make this day, you know, we pay tribute to your parents and to your family. Because it is through them that they have instilled in you the song of life. And today you will create a new song, the smash hit of your lives, a song that you will be known by. And I pray, my dear friends, on this day that you will always remember that before God, before your families and each other, will say, I do. From this day forward, you know, I will cherish and love you for the rest of my life, because our readings today speaks about it. But it also speaks and invites us deeper into that Christ should always be at the heart of your relationship. And I pray that God will bless you to be the bestest of lovers to each other, to be the bestest of friends. I pray that God will bless you to be great parents. And I hope and pray that you will have many children to look after you and care for you as you begin this journey here in this church. 27 years ago, I celebrated my first Mass here in this church. And I remember then, you know, a long time ago, as I was a young priest, that there was a couple here who'd been married for so long. But one day they came and told me a story. They said, because they've been married so long, the wife is always worried about the husband. You know, he wakes up in the morning and he says he's got a sore foot, sore back, sore hand, and she puts him in the car and drives him down Liverpool emergency. This happens nearly every week. And I was told that the doctor says they should not come to the emergency for a sore back or sore foot or sore hand or sore head. They should go to their medical doctor. And so one day, after a couple of weeks of this, you know, the doctor said, I'm going to put a stop to this. You know, the man, they came that morning, and he said he's got a sore foot. So after examining him, the doctor said to the wife, can you wait here, and your husband, can you go outside and wait for me? Because I want to talk to your wife privately. This is how the doctor was going to stop all this. And he said to the wife, look, your husband is not traveling very well and he's going to die. But if you do these things, I'm going to recommend you do beginning tomorrow for one whole year, I guarantee you'll be alright. So tomorrow morning, wake up early and fix him a nice breakfast, fix him a nice lunch, fix him, you know, a nice dinner. Your husband should be chores free from doing any work around the house for one whole year. You know, and your husband also must be told by the children that he's the best dad in the whole world. And at You know, he's ready to bed. You know, will you give him a massage? Do that for 1 hour. Don't miss a day, and I guarantee you're right. So they're traveling back. Oh, he's driving the car, anxious to know what the doctor said to his wife. Hey, dear, what did the doctor say to you? She turned around and said, you're going to die. She wasn't going to do any of those things. But Maria, you need to look after Reid, okay? And Reid, you need to look after Maria. Congratulations to both of you for this beautiful day that you have been dreaming about. Thank you for asking Father Ita, myself, and inviting all of us to be here. And thank you that COVID is now literally gone, because all of you, some of you were on the B list, but now you're all invited to celebrate this day, because it is a beautiful day in the lives of these two beautiful people. And so, my friends, congratulations. Today you are now going to begin a new chapter of your journey together. And so I invite you both now to come forward and to pledge your love for each other. Maria and Reid, the promise you made today to each other is serious, because it will bind you together for life in a relationship so close and so intimate that it will profoundly influence your whole future. That future, with its hopes and disappointments, its successes and its failures, its pleasures and its pains, its joys and its sorrow, is hidden from your eyes. But you know that these elements are mingled in every life and are to be expected in your own. And so, not knowing what is before you, but trusting in God's companionship, you take each other through the best and worst of what lies ahead until death. I invite you now to join your hands, as I also invite, you know, your best man and matron of honor to come forward to witness, you know, these wedding vows as you commit to yourselves to each other forever. My friends, you have declared your consent before God, your family, and your friends. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined today, man must not divide. Amen. My friends, we come to this part of our celebration where I'm sure they shouldn't be nervous at. I'm sure they've had a lot of practice at it. The first kiss is husband and wife. Before I ask them to do this, if you're sitting next to your husband or your wife, you might like to hold their hands at this time. If you're sitting next to a single person and you are single yourself,
united in marriage.
especially this holy bond that we're here to celebrate. We ask, Lord, that you bless these humble gifts that we offer on behalf of Maria and Reid, for we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and the fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth in baptism gives increase to the church. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we are praying. In a ia fa'atas te kia mātou e mātuta ai tasi e lea nāna paia. Lea ni ia ia manatua lau i kādesi e le lauwangi ātua, ina ia mātou horai le loka fa'atasi ma palamsisi no mātou te mātpaia. Ato niu no mātou te apti e pina pō, ma le intuain sa malaba ai maise lau whanau o fa'atasia e le isa palamenta o le whaai o tōna. Ia e manatua o mātou usu matua whāpine o koi atu o lātou mālo nunga ma le whāho e moe le toe tu wai. Ia e tahi a lātou whātasi ma tangata māri ni uma i le māmalama o lālo fio. Ia e lofa mai a te mātou malama i le mātou au mā mātou te au whātasi. I le ola e whāho lau ma māri a le tinata o koko le atua. Iosef o pai a whātasi ma le au ako o stolo ma le au pai au mao e na whātau uina lōtinga nalo i tuku lau. Mātou te pia ni ni ma wha ane ne e whātasi, mai lātou i nāu whio, e lātou lo wano o Iesu ke riso. Le to māma mana e ono i a whātasi mai e ono i a te ia, i le māta mama le ana ngā pāia, o le mi ngā mai ma manu ato o i nāu a whio, i le whāpa.
But all these favorite words and my soul shall be healed.
After I give communion to Maria and Reid, there will be two of us giving communion to those of you that wish to receive communion. If you do not receive communion and would like a blessing, please feel free to do so. Just place your hand like this so that we know you're just asking for a blessing.
Thank you.
uniting them as one. I ask you, the parents, to be up here because the most precious gift of your lives as parents and your love is your children. And so join me as I ask God's blessing in on Maria and Reid as they begin this journey of love. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginning of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, you consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with the one blessing, not forfeited by original sin or washed away in the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, so that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, make these your servants, Maria and Reid, hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments. One in flesh, may they be blameless in all they do, with the strength that comes from the gospel. May they bear true witnesses to Christ before all, may they be blessed with children, and prove themselves virtuous parents, who live to see their children's children, and grant that, reaching at last together the fullness of years, for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven. We make this prayer of blessing through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'm now going to invite the whole bridal party to come up and stand next to Maria, you know, and also Reid as they sign the government and the church papers.
I can't believe it's true. I'm standing here in front of you, and you are here with me. So unbelievable, I never ever let you go. My heart is yours for keeps. Thank you.
standing here in front of you, and you are hearing me.
As we're just getting them the official portrait, you know, could I now take this opportunity to Maria's dad, who wants to say a few things. Thank you. to all of you for being here. What a great opportunity for us to honor these two beautiful people as we celebrate with them later with the kind invitation, you know, for all of us. So I'd like to now present to you Mr. and Mrs. McCarthy.
Guys, 1, 2, and 3! Woo! Come on, guys, you can do better than this.
Thank you.
Okay, now,
oh my God,
let's have the bride parents. Okay, Dad, just back a little bit for you. Fantastic. Hold it there, please.
Oh, I never got a
hold it. Smiling, guys.
I was looking.
Beautiful. One more. Okay, beautiful. Stay there, guys. Call them over.
Sister, Nobby, Nancy, Mama.
Bride, sisters, and brothers, please.
Siblings, please. Bride, siblings.
Gotta go, Tom, dad, sir.
All girls, no brothers.
Okay, hold it. Okay, sweetheart, move back a little bit for you. Excellent. Turn your head and look at me. Hold it, guys. Hold it there. Beautiful. Okay. Can we get the groom side now with siblings? Mum and dad of the groom, please.
Mum and dad of the groom. Groom is mum. Mum. Mum, we just need you another photo, please. Mum.
Lisa. Come on.
Yep.
And the brother, the groom's brother, please.
Ian.
He's right there.
Oh, awesome. No sunnies. Sunnies off. Thanks, man. Squeeze in, people. Squeeze in. Transitions or no?
Does anyone know how to fly to the island?
Tala. Come back just a fraction.
We don't know.
Okay, ready, ready, ready. Look at me, guys. We have a poser. Thank you.
Lucky.
I got it. Yeah. Okay. Got your friend?
Oh, okay. I'm gonna go pass that one over. I know.
Hi, Paula.
Hi, Paula.
Hi.
Paula, Moimoi.
Say hi, Madeline.